Then we have the Love in a Mug, which has been very much discussed now because of the dengue epidemic in some areas where we have been using the diagnostic kit. Okay, the Love in a Mug is a more generic term that actually can cover several diagnostic kits. Okay, not only dengue, you have the leptospirosis, and now we are perfecting the tuberculosis lab in a mug. Then the Bigormin, which is water treatment discovery from the laboratories of Adamson University, funded by Fischer DOST. Next slide. Additional examples. This has been much talked about already. I will not discuss this anymore. The hybrid electric train. The next slide. This is, I think, these are some of the things that have been contributing to our improvement in industry academic collaboration, and also in terms of the number of. You remember in human resource as a pillar, we had the number of graduates and what was the other term that was used? Yung tatlo, the number of graduates, the second one, pakibalikan nga nyo yun, research talent, okay? I think here, our program, balik na natin dun sa Science for Change. Okay, that NICER program, which is needs centers in the regions, for R&D has the objective of expanding our R&D pool, okay? So that we are not dependent only on a few universities, okay? In terms of implementing R&D programs, now we have more than a dozen just for 2019 that has been added to this list of needs research centers in the region. Later on, you can see where they are located. In fact, I would like to shorten my discussion so that there will be time for our media personnel, media guests to take a look at our maps where you can see where the NICER centers are located, where the Cradle partnerships are located, where our business incubators are located, etc., etc. So these are the components of Science for Change, where we want to expand our capability to do research in the regions, not only because they know better the problems in the region, but also because they know more about the opportunities which can be tapped through R&D. Okay, the R&D lead, okay, is a way of strengthening also our needs research centers. So they come from the pool of expert scientists, including balik scientists, that can help our NICER centers develop their research program. Cradle has been coming up with a synergistic relationship, which is resulting in new products, new technologies, and solutions to technology problems. Next. Next slide is okay. So I mentioned earlier that there were major pieces of legislation that has helped us, and one of them actually was the Technology Transfer Act. I still remember that very vividly because I was deeply involved, as well as the people here, like Director Sabular said. We were all involved in Technology Transfer Act, which became law in 2009 and which was put into effect in 2010. And the Technology Transfer Act, among other things, encourages our researchers to be more productive in terms of innovations because the ownership, okay, of the technology or the intellectual property that will be generated will not go to DOST, it will go to the research institution that did the research, okay? And therefore, the economic benefits will go to them also. No more share for the funding institution, unlike before, when the funding institution got one half of the economic benefits. Now it's 100% going into the implementer of the research, and divided between the institution and the researchers. Okay, so now we are already we have started to distribute royalty payments to our researchers. They may not be big amounts, but for a start, I think it gives them a lot of satisfaction that they are receiving royalty payments for the intellectual property that they have generated. So you can see here in the Balik Scientist program, I will not go into details of the accomplishments, but our target here is to increase the number of Balik scientists by a factor of, was it 50% every year, so that by the end of 2022, from the usual 30 to 35 or up to 40 that we are getting, we can move up to something like close to 160 or 150 Balik scientists in a year. Still a modest figure, but they can actually contribute much. Next is the next slide. Okay, the most recent, of course, among the pieces of legislation from bill to a law is the Philippine Space Act, where we had a separate, I think, presentation on this. Particularly when we inaugurated the ULISSES project, which is the University Laboratory for Space for Small Satellites and Space Engineering at the University of the Philippines. So, passed into law not more than 1 month ago, August 8, ano ba ngayon? September 5, okay? Wala pang 1 month. Kaya lang hindi siya under the OST. Siya ay under the Office of the President. Okay? And there is a Space Council that will govern it, I mean, policy-wise, chaired by the President of the Philippines with two vice chairs, namely the Secretary of DOST and the Secretary of the Department of National Defense. So you can see there our people at work, okay? And the different areas where the law, okay, will actually focus on, or the agency will focus on, focusing on national security, on hazard management, on space R&D, on space industry capacity building, on education, and on international cooperation. Next slide, going back to the innovation pillars where we have discussed human resource, business sophistication, and knowledge and technology outputs, maybe we can skip this slide and go to the next, just to show that our industry-academic collaboration has already moved on from the initial four projects in 2018. There are now 18 approved projects. This is to create a synergistic relationship between academia and industry with the goal of invigorating Philippine research and development. As I have said many times before, we have two groups very eager to do research, the academe, the professors, for example, and the industry, okay? The academe, professors are very eager to do R&D because, number one, it is now part, okay, of their university functions, not only to teach, but also to do research and extension work. Number two, because they want, okay, to be recognized through their publications and the intellectual properties that they will own, and ultimately, of course, that will bring them up to either to be promoted, or some of them can even launch their own startup technology companies. But now we bring them closer to industry, because the industry wants to do research to solve their problems, to discover new products and new technologies. For example, one of the favorite topics in the collaboration is how to make use of the potential out of the waste products that are discarded in the manufacture of goods. where there is still value that can be obtained, no? So for example, you talk of pineapple, okay? You get the pineapple slices, okay, that are canned and exported, but there is so much material still that remains where you can extract new products, okay? As an example, and here we have disbursed a total of 87 million, okay? We justify that because the knowledge that is discovered anyway, okay, is still owned by the public. I mean, although there is of course the first preference for the partner, but ultimately this will become additional knowledge that can be shared. Next is examples of projects under the Cradle project, which is really the collaboration between industry and academia. Teka muna, wag muna niyo ilipat. TIP, okay, Technological Institute of the Philippines, one of the private higher educational institutions that came first to apply for a Cradle grant, okay? And this is the use of artificial intelligence on medicinal drug discovery, okay? So, because there are so many ingredients that you will find in a plant that is known to have medicinal value, and you shorten the process of identifying the shall we say the most promising through artificial intelligence. Okay, next example. Hindi na pala example ito. These are statistics on intellectual property filings for the so-called ITSO member institutions. ITSO, these are the intellectual ano nga yun, these are the universities, okay? This is actually a collaboration between us and IPO, okay? Where we create ITSO offices in different universities. These are the technology, kalimutan ko na yung ITSO, ibig sabihin ng ITSO. Kasi yung word na yan, hindi naman DOST ang nag-coin, it was coined by IPO. Okay? So these are offices that cater to the IP concerns of the universities. Okay? Next, we have our support to technology transfer. This is done by a number of programs also, depending on the kind of clientele. So we have Fast Track is a funding assistance for spin-off and the translation of research in advancing commercialization. Okay, so funding assistance for spin-off and translation of research in advancing commercialization. So that's the program called Fast Track. The other one is IMPACT, Intellectual Property Management Program for Academic Institutions Commercializing Technologies. So, kita nyo na magkakaiba yung clients dito. Sa una, siya yung mga nag-i-spin-off. Isa naman sa universities or institutions. Yung pangatlo is elevating the DOST-TBI network services and programs from the level where we used to operate, now targeting industry level 4.0. And we have the HEIRIT, okay, pakibasa nga Raul kung ano yung sabihin ng HEIRIT.
Higher Education Institution Readiness for Innovation and Technopreneurship.
Higher Education Institution Readiness
for Innovation and Technopreneurship.
For Innovation and technopreneurship. This is really the incubator program, okay? And then we have the Startup Nation, which actually is a grant given to startups, okay, more for furthering product development through research, okay? So magkaka-related yan, and although iba-ibang categories, yung isa doon mismo sa mga nag-i-spin off, yung isa naman doon sa institutions, okay? Yung isa naman ay yung pag-ooperate ng incubators, okay? And then the other one is really to further the research so that it will be become a mature and ready to market product. Next, our relocation of our technology business incubators. Mamaya makikita niyo doon sa map. Now we have 44 of them, and it is not confined to the so-called IT type of incubating companies. We have also agricultural startups that are incubated in some universities. I think there are 12 universities that are focusing on agri-based startups. Then the next slide are examples of the so-called DOST assisted startups that have already, shall we say, graduated into full-blown enterprises. Okay, Rurok Industries, ito ba yung sa bisikleta? Okay, Retailgate, okay, which is more of more on the pricing data on retailing. And then you have the Mashibax, Futuristic Aviation and Maritime Enterprises, Nanotronics, Cropital, Senti, Farmwatch, Grayscale, Bigormin. Okay, familiar ako sa Rurok, familiar ako sa Bigormin, familiar ako sa Nanotronics at sa Retailgate. Yung Nanotronics, sila talaga yung nag-develop ng mga products na nanotechnology particles, mostly coming from natural products, okay? Actually, different sources. At yun ang ginagamit ngayon as inputs, as raw materials to produce products. Okay? So yung dati, halimbawa, ng mga, yung mga usual polymers ang ginagamit, ngayon, nanotechnology particles na ang ginagamit. Okay? Kung hindi ako nagkakamali, yung nag-umpisa niyan was, taga Mapua ba yun? O? Lasal. Okay, pero lumipat siyang naging teacher sa Mapua, and then until he transferred to AIM pa yata. So marami siyang pinuntahan. Until ngayon, meron na siyang company. Next is the location of our NYSER centers. So there are now 15 that has been approved. You will notice that the amount that we have devoted to this is a significant amount of more than half a billion pesos. And you can see the kind of expertise that they have. Very, very specific and narrow, but they have a very strong capability to do research in that area. Okay? So, pwede na rin silang mag-offer, or some of them are already offering MS and PhD in these specific areas or related to these specific areas. So, karamihan po sa kanila ay agriculture related pa rin itong unang batch, and we understand that because in the regions, most of the universities are originating from agricultural colleges. Some of them are coming from the trade institutes, but most of them are coming from the agricultural colleges na naging universities. So freshwater fisheries in Isabela, citrus for Nueva Vizcaya, astronomy for Rizal Technological University, potato for Benguet, sweet potato for Tarlac, tamarind for Pampanga, disaster risk related management health for UP Manila, crustacean in Samar State U, mollusk in UP Visayas, environmental informatics in UP Cebu, biodiversity in Cebu Technological University, industrial tree plantations in Caraga, and Siku Kumber in MSU Naawan, renewable energy for Ateneo de Manila University in Region 11. Next slide are some of the infrastructure or institutions that have been recently established, okay, which brings us to a higher level in terms of the so-called modern or emerging technologies, okay? Tinatandaan ko yung initials niyan usually GNR. Sino makakahula yung sabihin ng GNR? G is for genomics, N is for nanotechnology, and R is for robotics. Ito yung mga emerging technologies ngayon na nagiging major platforms for R&D. Genomics, nanotechnology, and robotics. What is in common in these fields? Okay, they bring together several basic disciplines. So in genomics, you have biology, you have physics, you have IT brought together. In nanotechnology, ganun din, meron kang chemistry, meron kang physics, okay? Meron kang material science. In robotics, of course, you have mechanical, electrical, electronics put together. So ito yung common sa mga so-called emerging technologies where we have already made ourselves capable, okay? For the Genome Center, the first one was set up in UP Diliman. The second one will be set up in Manduriaw. Ah, tama ba yun? In UP Visayas, I think. In sa Visayas. Miag-au. Yeah, in Miag-au, where you have UP Visayas, and I think in Mindanao, in southeastern. UP Mindanao. In UP Mindanao. In kasi nga pala itong Genome Center ay nagsimula as a collaboration between UP and DOST. So yung mga susunod pa is still a collaboration between UP and DOST with the help of CHED. Let us not forget the help that CHED has been given to this. The next one are dito Class Luna Centers. You can see them again in the maps. And I always tell this story that when we started, yun ang kainaman po nang nandun na sa DOST nung araw. I remember that it was only DOST and UP Manila that were collaborating for drug discovery and development. And you know, it takes a long time. Ngayon, there are 10 universities that are involved doing the different aspects from screening of the plants and marine samples, okay, to the testing for harmful effects and toxicity, to the isolation of the active ingredients that have potentials to cure certain diseases, up to a certain point, yung mga universities. Beyond, siyempre, yung mga clinical trials ay limited na rin doon sa mga may malalaking ospital. No? Kasi dyan ka makakakuha ng mga pasyente. So into Class Lunas, while we are talking of more than 1,000 possible species from our rich biodiversity, as of now, 2019, we are ready to proceed with 18 of these for either the manufacture of the active ingredients, kasi yung active ingredients, pwede mo naman siyang isynthesize. Or pwede ka nang tumuloy sa clinical trials, okay? Kung gusto mong maging gamot. Now, ano ba yung sasabihin ko? To Class Lunas. Kasi yung clinical trials is an expensive activity. So, we do not foresee all to graduate into the clinical trials stage. Maybe the clinical trials can be done by the private sector, okay? And even from the foreign companies, we anticipate that there will be interest from foreign companies, but they have to pay us. Now we have other than to Class Lunas. Sige pa, next slide. Ito naman yung may kinalaman sa advanced device and materials testing, ADMATEL, which most of you have seen already. Ang kagandahan dito, nag-expand na siya ng clientele from the usual semiconductors and electronics, they're now into the other clientele, okay, which includes the pharmaceutical industries, also the space technology, okay, and other industries that are doing testing now at the ADMATEL. Next, Ito naman yung more for the development of new products. This will richly enhance our innovation capacity. Kasi dito, welcome ang mga researchers, welcome ang mga small entrepreneurs, welcome ang estudyante, ang mga teachers na gustong magkutingting at mag-develop ng consumer products and electronics. Yan ang facilities na nandiyan, the printed circuit board prototyping and fabrication facility. So hindi ka na mamumroblema kung saan ka magpapagawa ng printed circuit board, EMC and other test facility. Raul, ano nga EMC?
Electromagnetic compatibility
and of course the product prototyping laboratory itself, okay, where you assemble the components and come up with a working consumer product. Next, we have the Food Innovation Centers. Ito medyo luma na sa inyo to kasi sinimulan yan as early as 5 years ago. Noong panahon pa ni Secretary Montejo, inimpisahan ng mga FICs. But really, it has revolutionized new product development in the regions, no? Yung mga processed food. So that in a matter of, halimbawa dito, in 2018 alone, there were 2,000, almost 3,000 new product concepts that were generated, resulting in more than 400 new products that were developed with 70 intellectual properties filed and 1,618 customers served. Mostly, these are our SMEs. Pupunta sila doon, naiisip nila yung produkto, paano ba gagawin ito, tutulungan sila doon. Next! One Lab, ito naman yung mga IT-based networks natin na pinapadali ease of doing business on the part of our clientele. So itong One Lab, kahit saan ka nandun, kahit yung laboratory na nandun sa lugar mo, limited lang ang mga test na isinasagawa, pwede mo isubmit ang sample mo at bahala na yung laboratory na yon sa logistics para makarating dun sa laboratory which can do the analysis. It can be in another location. And you can see now the figures. We start with the 6 national R&D laboratories that we have in Bicutan, in Diliman, and in Los Baños. And then we have the 15 regional standards and testing laboratories. 15 lang po kasi walang sariling laboratory ang DOST-NCR. Kasi ang DOST-NCR ay nandito na mismo sa lugar kung saan nandun yung mga national laboratories. And then we have 30 non-DOST laboratories. Some are private, some are from other departments like the Department of Health and the Department of Agriculture. Next, we have the demonstration of the DOST innovation landscape. Dito na tayo pumunta dyan sa mga mapa na yan. Meron pa ba susunod na slide? Ha? Wala na. Kaya bago tayo magkaroon ng mga tanungan, gusto naming ibitahan ang ating mga media people. Well, actually kung meron kayong hawak na laptop pa, pwedeng ikaw nga magpaliwanag, Lawrence, kung paano. Kasi ako, ang gusto ko naman ay imbitahan yung pair by pair, no? Dalawa-dalawa, pumunta sa harap para lang ma-demonstrate kung sino. Okay? Magtambal lang isang bata at saka isang hindi bata. Okay? Sino unang pupunta sa harap? Isang pares. Okay? Okay, sige, pumunta na kayo. Pumunta na kayo. Tuturo ni Lawrence kung ano gagawin. At gamitin mo na itong microphone.
So, magandang hapon po sa ating mga kasamaan sa media.
Test.
So, dito po makita nyo yung tinatawag nating DOST Innovation Landscape. Yung mapa po kung nasaan makita lahat ng mga DOST centers. So, kung meron po kayong dalang laptop or kung meron po kayong connection sa internet, makita po ito sa DOST website. So dito po sa gilid, sa quick links ng DOST website, makita niyo po, DOST Innovation Landscape. Pwede niyo pong i-click yan, tapos i-redirect niyo po kayo dun sa landing page no mapa natin ng DOST. So nandyan po nakalagay lahat ng mga sentro na tinayo ng DOST para tumulong sa innovation ng bansa. So for example, gusto kong makita kung nasaan yung mga
business incubator.
Business incubators natin. So, click ko lang po na iba.
Kung nasaan ang balik scientist natin, kung nasaan yung mga nicer centers natin.
Balik na tayo.
Okay.
So, para sa mga BSPs po, lalabas po dyan yung mga BSP. Tapos, kiklik nyo po. Kunyari, ako ay nasa isang region. So, pwede ko i-click. Kunyari, yan. Sa Holy Angel University sa Pampanga. So, ito si Engineer Leo Almasan. Nandun siya para tumulong sa Holy Angel mag-develop ng mga research and development projects nila.
So for example, ang nakaklik sa'yo ngayon, yung balik scientist?
Yes, sir.
Okay. O, sige.
For example, sa TBI naman.
Yeah, pag-turuan mo yung dalawang nasa unahan na yan. Sila.
Click niya ako yung TBI. Tapos, kunyari, gusto ko, since yung negosyo or yung startup ko, malapit kunyari sa Manila, so pupunta ako sa Manila, or sa location of interest ko. Tapos, i-click ko yung TBI sa Manila. And then, papakita niya sa University of Santo Tomas, ito yung tawag sa TBI. So, Tomasino Center TBI. Papakita niya kung ano yung mga banner programs niya. So, for example, dito, Rehabilitation Engineering. So, kung yung startup ko malapit sa ganung klase ng negosyo, dito ako mag-house. For example naman, kung medyo iba pa yung center ng business ko, punta ako sa AIM, Daduba na tao, Incubator. So, ayun naman, makita yung ibang TBI sa pwede akong mag-locate.
Kaya mo pumindot si Cathy.
Yeah. Ma'am.
Ito, One Lab.
So, One Labs as...
So, taga-QC ako.
Opo. So, saan po ang pinakamalapit na One Lab Center? So, yung One Lab po is a network ng mga laboratories ng DOST. So, for example, meron akong kailangan testing, kahit na wala siya dito sa Manila, ipapadala siya dun sa ibang testing sites through One Lab. So, for example, meron lang siya somewhere sa Visayas, yung testing na yun. So, yung One Lab na yung mag-aasikaso for that testing. So dito, for example, sa Region 4A, sa Calabarzon, pwede yung dalhin dyan yung samples nyo. So kahit hindi available sa Calabarzon, yung testing or analysis, ipapadala dun sa network kung saan pwedeng gawin yung analysis through One Lab. So ease of doing business, kumbaga. Hindi na kailangan mag-transport. Yung One Lab na yung bahala para doon.
Another pair naman, another pair.
Next pair daw po ng media na gustong sumubok ng map natin. Ano
yung pares para lang ma-experience?
Volunteers.
Si Ate Esther.
So, Ate Mavic, pakita natin yung mga FIC centers. So, FIC.
Do not be afraid.
Natakot po yata siya sa akin. Opo. Sirs, ma'am. Yeah.
Halika, sir, rin din.
Sir, so ito po yung mapa. So for example, ano po yung gusto natin makita? Kayong mga nicer programs?
Oh yeah, nicer naman ang hanapin niyo.
Pwede niyo pong pindutin yung nicer dito. Ako. Quezon City, so...
Ayun, nasa kanan yung lumabas.
Opo, yung nicer. So, kunyari ito. Sige po, touch nyo po. Ayan, kayo. Sa Quezon City, may doon tayong Nicer. Ito po, pipindot nyo po yung logo ng Nicer. So, ito yung isa malapit sa Quezon City, yung sa Mandaluyong. Yung Center for Astronomy, R&D. Yan. Okay, tapos yung isa pong Nicer na malapit sa region. Yan, yung Center for Disaster Risk Reduction naman sa UP Manila. So, makita nyo po yung ginagawa niya doon, tapos yung mga proyekto niya.
So, ano nga, yung sa Isabela, tingnan niya.
Sa Isabela po na Nicer.
North yun, Region 2.
Yan, sir. Freshwater fishery sa Isabela. Po.
Citrus, ano ba? Ayun, freshwater.
Yung halala.
Yung halala sa laboratory yun.
Opo.
Walang separate.
Walang po separate sa halal ako.
Kasi tatlo pa lang yun
Next, sino?
Another pair.
Rose.